instruments. In general, you see there's a lot of equipment. I have my laptop here. I'm not checking my email. I have, the airlines like to have me on board, you know. And I think only bass players and percussionists can understand my my troubles, you know. So, what I'm doing basically is I'm looking inside the instrument. There is a whole orchestra inside. When you have, when I was studying and practicing, I heard many things, many sounds of the flute, which my teacher at the time didn't like, you know, like key clicks, air, whistle, all kind of dirty tonguing. And of course you want to avoid that for the aesthetics of the music we play in the traditional repertoire. But I think it was too, they were too interesting to just let them beside. And so what I did, I basically recycled them. And then I always had the feeling they were not as attractive as they could be. And I started putting amplification into the flute. So I have microphones that look inside the flute here, that see the, you know, the air coming by, the Chinese meals flying by. And I have one microphone here, and one from the other end, and I'm triggering them with a volume control. And this is just to travel, this equipment. And when you look at the quality of the sound, it's, if you have this, or this, so what I'm doing is I'm just going closer to the instrument with a magnifying glass and make it, and bring it through the speakers that you can hear the things I'm hearing. Then of course a whole technique developed, playing technique as well. And so this is what comes out of it. I just say this because sometimes people come up after a concert, come up to me and say, it's just great what you can do with a synthesizer. So this is all a natural product, you know. It's all from the inside of the instrument, of the flute. Sometimes when you do research and you develop your instrument and you go one direction and you discover many things, and then you come back to some very early music, then of course you ask yourself, why all this, you know? So I came by a wonderful collection of pieces by Diego Ortiz, a composer from the Renaissance. It's a book called Tratado de Glossas from the 16th century when he was living in Rome. And it's actually a method for ornamentation for viola da gamba. And I had the feeling always when I was playing, I had the feeling it reminded me somehow something between didgeridoo and viola da gamba, you know. And so I ended up playing some Renaissance tunes, which I would like to do here as well. Thank you.
Thank you.